All right, so you've seen this Dell laptop before, probably. But what about this? Well, that kind of looks familiar, but not from Dell. Say hello to the new XPS 13 2-in-1 laptop. So, the newly refreshed XPS 2-in-1, with a ton of cool new features, comes with a price tag of, we don't know yet. It's a little ambiguous at the moment, because Dell hasn't fully released this product yet, since its trailer is still unlisted. But given that the 2020 XPS 13 2-in-1 and the Surface Pro 8, probably the main competitor of this laptop, start at $1,100, you can guess that this will be around that too. But no promises. Either way, the laptop has a fairly good screen with a quote, up to 3K resolution, which also means that resolution probably doesn't come with the starter model, but that's just a hunch. But something I really like about this laptop is its new, more tablet-like design. It resembles the Surface Pro 8, which, as you can tell by my channel, I really like, because it's super versatile, being both very portable because of its form factor and fairly high-performing. But I do understand that some people might not like this laptop now, because it looks less like a laptop. The design is far different compared to the original, catering more to the tablet side of the 2-in-1 form factor as opposed to the laptop end, which some people will like, and some people won't. And with this new design, there are sacrifices to be made. Specifically, the connectivity of this device suffers pretty bad. You get two USB-C ports. That's it. So you lose both the SD card reader and headphone jack in this new design in favor of just USB-C, which is, not the best. On one hand, yeah, it does make the laptop look cleaner by not having many ports on the side, and it does also make the laptop look thinner. But on the other hand, it's not as practical for power users, who this device is probably tailored toward. However, allegedly, Dell is remedying its connectivity by adding a USB-C to USB-A adapter, which, if I'm being honest, is not enough. How about the headphone jack and the SD card reader? It really is a shame to have so few ports in this nice new laptop. But moving on, this device's internal specs do make up for its lack in connectivity to some degree. The laptop comes with the new 12th gen Intel processors, either the i5 or the i7, which are very fast and are likely the reason why this device still hasn't been released yet, or at least why its trailer is still unlisted on YouTube, due to the global chip shortage. We'll just have to wait and see when this device releases in August to get a better understanding of the situation. But one thing that's very clear to me is the storage. 256GB, which is way too low at this price range. But either way, you can get an external SSD, and any of these will work. Now, I want to acknowledge one thing that Dell does deserve credit for, the camera system. According to Dell's blog post, the laptop sports a 1080p front camera and a 4K rear, which is pretty good for the first iteration of this design. And in terms of battery capacity, we get a sizable 49.5Wh battery, which does sound like, on its own, an arbitrary measurement. But, given that its processors are fairly efficient, the laptop will have a pretty good battery life. And lastly, the device does run Windows 11. So, then, who is this device really made for? Well, given that it's competing with the Surface Pro 8, probably students and traveling professionals. And one thing that I think Dell realized is the premium 2-in-1 laptop market is really untouched, especially the tablet end of things. The only competition really is Microsoft with its Surface line, Apple with its iPads that aren't even 2-in-1s, and a few other companies. It really does seem like an untapped goldmine. So I see what Dell is doing here with its product, but is it really better than the competition? That depends on the price. But from what I can tell, it'll be an interesting battle. The new XPS 13 2-in-1 seems like a good device, but against the Surface Pro, we'll see. But in comparison to other Dell products, I think this is a pretty big step in a good direction, because it's a very new take for Dell in the 2-in-1 market. The laptop is very portable, and it seems like it's fairly high performing. And so, if you're looking for a laptop when this device releases, be sure to check it out, because it is some cool tech. But anyway, if you'd like to read more about this device, I've got links about it down in the description. My name is Cyrus. It's spelled like Cyrus, pronounced like See Rooster, just take out the ter. Thank you very much for watching, and have a wonderful day. Peace.